our dice.
Welcome to this Today's Codecast. This is episode number 81 in our series, Create a RubyGem Nerd Dice. And we were in the middle of refactoring some code in the previous episode. We'll continue doing that. All right, back to failing. Number to keep and parse number to keep. Nil. Get number to keep from method name. Roller total here. Advantage or disadvantage. All right, so it should be excluding the highest die, but it is not, because my number to keep is nil here. Change how I'm doing this all together. So let's pseudocode this out. Okay, so I think the issue here is our match data. Specified number. This would be advantage or disadvantage with the number, and then first. So now we know that the number to keep so our specified number. We'll give that and then we need to determine the default here. So this is only in the situation where deciding number of dice. Okay. So default will be write a better comment here. So that person who was later maintaining the code and trying to deal with this was me. So it was kind of a dangerous thing to do to begin with. Let me rewrite this comment. All right, so let's see if that fixes things. It does. Back to passing. That is exciting. Okay. I'll clean up the put statements in a second here, but let's see. So get rid of both of these. I can do the same thing with total. Similar situation there. We have the advantage or disadvantage. And then in define total, to keep. In total here, let me see if we can just get rid of these methods. Alright, so I've got a bad pattern here somewhere. Thank you. number to keep. That wrapping block. Okay, so all of our advantage disadvantage is broken right now, which is not a problem yet. So keep. Have number to keep, then if number to keep, then roll dice, and then we would call parse number to keep dot total. Oh, that's working. Okay, so let's I guess we can just go back to our single method name here, since we've only got these can go bye bye. Define role, define total. These can go. And stay gone. Alright, find all of our puts statements and get rid of those. Offenses, empty line after guard clause. Twelve are auto correctable. Let's take care of those. Still passing. See what Rubocop is still fussing about. So, method length has too many lines. Method has too many lines. Useless assignment. Second match. Down to two, and they're both related to method length. So those we can just do a dereferenced variable, I think. So we can do F from method name and number of dice we need. Number of dice. We actually don't need it because we can get it from there. Break anything. One offense. 13 out of 10 on total. Method name, so we've got modifier we don't need anymore at this point. So we do need name. We need sides. Number to keep. Keyword arguments. Just do the same thing here. So I might not need this at all. Sides modifier. I think I can do this, so method name, keyword arguments, I get the rest of them from there. Let's see if it works. Oh, it did not. It very much did not. Keyword arguments. Oh, we are close here. Commented code can just go away. Rubocop is happy. Let's see how happy. Oh, 7 lines. So this is the one I think where we can harvest some of these out. So default equals data unmatched parentheses. That's working. 102. Oh, we're so close. Let's see here. Anything else we can? This modifier from method name, I might be able to get a little bit more out of here. I think I've found my opportunity here. So this get bonus and get penalty from method name, they're only called from this method, so I might be able to just do some one-liners here. Passing. Oh, assignment branch condition size now is too high. It was worth a shot. Let's just do get modifier. So all right. Go back to the previous situation here. Match data is positive. Modifier with match data. All So, let's see if I broke anything. Oh, I did. Let's see what I broke. Only everything. Undefined method name. Get modifier method name. Matched it. Oh, just. Try this back to passing and Rubocop has relented, so that is exciting. I've only changed this one file. Create the commit message. All right, so I've got the commit message, sign it. Push to the remote. Move this to done. Let our action complete. And we're green.
Thanks for watching this stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding, and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.